So in this session, we will try to go through the syllabus of the Pharmacology Lab 2, and we will try to see, and we will try to start with the introduction of the Pharmacology Lab. Okay. So as this lab is not new for you, I have already taken class Pharmacology Lab 1. Okay. So basically, this lab is extension of that Pharmacology Lab 1. Okay. So you will not find everything new. Okay. The base is already clear to you. Just we have to learn the new things. Okay. So first of all, let me introduce you course outcomes. Okay. As I introduce course outcome in the theory. So in similar way, we are having course outcomes for the practicals. So now see the first course outcome. So the first course outcome is, at the end of this course, okay, you will be able to define the bioassay. Okay, this is, you should be able to define bioassay. Then you should be able to list the types, methods, and application of the bioassay. Okay, and perform in vitro bioassay using Coq-Ileum. So now see, first of all, you have to define what is bioassay. Then you have to list the types, then types, methods, and application of bioassay. And third one is, you have to perform in vitro bioassay method. And after performing, you should be able to record, okay, calculate and interpret the unknown concentration of agonist and antagonist of the drug. So see, there are so many activities. Okay, so the first activity is, you have to define what is bioassay. So today we will try to see the definition of bioassay and all. List of the types, method, application, that also we are going to see today. And regarding performance of in vitro bioassay using Coq-Ileum. So this is not possible in online mode. Okay, so I will be showing you the observations. I will be sharing with you the videos. With the help of videos, you should be able to understand the procedure. So that is only possible in online mode. Okay, but regarding recording, okay, recording of the readings. Okay, so recording is again not possible. So, but other that is calculation and interpretation is possible. So I will be giving you the raw data. You have to calculate the concentration. You have to perform calculations, and then finally you have to interpret the result. Okay, so that can be that we can do in online mode. So that is first course outcome. Second course outcome is, you have to observe preclinical models which provide evidences on drug or lead pharmacological activity. So what you have to do, you have to observe the preclinical model. Okay, so I will be showing you again video to clear you the preclinical models. Like I will show you anti-epileptic model. Okay, as we have started in theory epilepsy, so I will be showing you the animal model of the epilepsy. Okay, so you have to observe that observation, and finally at the end you have to again calculate. Okay, you have to calculate, yes, you have to calculate and interpret the unknown concentration of the drug. So what we will do, I will be explaining you the experiment. Okay, so there will be discussion on the experiment, and then after the experiment I will be giving you assignment through Google Classroom. Okay, then within that 3 hours only, see, our practical is of 3 hours, so within that 3 hours only you have to solve that problem. Okay, and then again we will be coming back for Viva. Okay, because see, in continuous assessment, Viva is the main component. So after each practical, we will be conducting on daily basis Viva. Okay, So that will be the procedure. Then I will be making groups amongst you. For example, how many students are there? Almost 26 to 27 students are there. So you can prepare a group of 5. Okay. So that will be there to encourage the peer-to-peer learning. Okay. For example, if I am in a group and I am having a doubt. So first, my teacher has already explained the concept. If I am having a doubt, so that doubt can be cleared by your peer, your colleague. So that is called as peer-to-peer learning. Even if that person or your colleagues are not able to answer that, so that group will come to me and I'll explain to them. Okay, so this is after my explanation. Okay, I'm not going to give directly you an assignment. You have to understand it and you have to clear your doubts. That will not be the procedure. I will be explaining you, and after explaining, if in within your peer group, if you are having any doubts, so you can clear it. Okay, so that is called as peer-to-peer learning. So that will be the method, explanation. Then second will be, I'm going to give you assignment. Then you have to solve that assignment. And then finally, there will be viva. Now come to third. Third one is relate to apply the ethical regulatory toxicity guidelines rule in drug lead testing using preclinical animals. So in this case, we will be learning the regulatory guidelines of conducting animal studies, preclinical studies. Okay, so last two experiments are given in your syllabus, which are related to CPC, OECD, ICH guidelines. And again, this is not new for you. We have already studied this in Pharmacology 1. Okay, so these are the course outcomes. Now come to the syllabus. See, the syllabus first topic is experiments. Okay, so in offline mode, you could have perform it. But in online mode, this will again convert to demonstration. Okay, because demonstration is a second topic. But this is also now demonstration. Right? This is also demonstration. So in demonstration, bioassay of acetylcholine, using suitable isolated tissue preparation. Okay, so in bioassay of acetylcholine, we are having different methods. Okay, so that all methods we have to study. Then in bioassay of atropine, using suitable isolated tissue preparation. So this also we have performed atropine, but still we have to perform this in pharmacology 2 also. Okay, so these two experiments are there, but again they are demonstration for you. Then third, next one is demonstration. So bioassay of oxytocin, behavioral pharmacological and demonstration with the help of simulation experiments. So iske andar jo hai locomotor activity, then muscle relaxant property, analgesic activity, anticonvulsant activity, and phenothiazine induced catalepsy. Okay, so all these are the different animal models. So these are the upper one are called as in vitro models. Okay, these are in vitro. And all these are called as in vivo models, right? Then the last one is toxicity study. So we have to complete the introduction of CPC, OECD guidelines, and introduction to subacute, and chronic toxicity studies. Okay, so these are the these all experiments we have to perform. So the syllabus is vast. Okay, we have to at least complete 4 to 5 experiment in experiment number 1. Okay, almost 4 experiments are there. Okay, this is 1. So this is 5, and then this is 6, then 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. Okay, so total 13 experiments we have to perform. okay, and the number of weeks are already almost 10 to number of sessions are almost 10. So what it means, we have to complete at least 2 experiment in one session so that we can have sufficient time for revision. Otherwise there will not be any time for revision. Okay, so at least in one session we will target 2 experiment, okay, within 3 hours, and it is possible because it's all are demonstrations. Okay, so it is possible. Yes, any question on this? Any query, any question? You can unmute or you can write in chat box. If no queries, then I can go ahead. I'm giving you 2 minutes.
No, sir, no query.
Okay, fine. So now we can start with the bioassay, introduction to bioassay. Okay, see. First of all, what is bioassay? Now see the term itself explaining. Okay, it is assay. Okay, in chemistry, you are performing this assay, you are finding out the percentage purity. You are finding out the percentage purity of the compound, unknown drug, or you are identifying the unknown drug, that is qualitative assay, and you are finding out the quantity of the active ingredient, that is called as percentage purity. So all that are chemical assay. But in this case, we are using organs of the animals or whole animal. So that's why it is called as bioassay. Okay, now let me introduce the formal definition. Procedures by which the potency or the nature of the substance is estimated by using its effect on living matter. Okay, what is bioassay? We are finding out potency, okay, and nature of the substance. Now see, in potency, if you can remember, we have drawn this graph. Okay, this is your response log dose, and this is the on y-axis you will be having your percent response. Okay, so at the end, what we have to find out, we have to find out the EC50 value. Okay, this is your 50% response. So this EC50 value, this EC50 value is nothing but its potency. Okay, so we can compare EC50 value of a test drug with the standard drug. So this EC50 is nothing but it is potency. We can find out the potency. Okay, this is your potency. Then on another hand, you can find out the nature of the substance. So the nature of the substance means either it will be agonist or antagonist. Right? So we can identify this agonist and antagonist with the help of bioassay. Okay? So this is bioassay. Now, bioassay are generally done using animal tissue, animal organs, and we are using cell. Okay, cells. So this is these are the main ingredient, main prerequisite for the bioassay. We should have animal, we should have animal organ, we should have animal tissue, or we should have animal cells with us. Then I can share with you examples like guinea pig ileum. Okay, ileum, okay, organ of the animal, is used for estimation of histamine, or using intact animal. Okay, then bioassay of insulin using mice, or digitalis bioassay using guinea pig. Okay, so see, in these examples we have ileum, that is the body organ, and we have whole animal, that is mouse and guinea pig. Okay, so the experimentation done on these animals are called as bioassay. Okay, Is it clear to all? If you have any doubt, let me know. You can write in chat box or you can unmute. What I have explained to you is the basics of the bioessay. Definition of bioessay, requirement of bioessay, and I have shared with you example. Okay, see, after every 15 to 20 minutes, I'm going to ask you questions. Okay, queries. Okay, so and that will not be application type. That will be only at the level of understanding. Okay, whether you have understood the concept or not. Okay, so it is better to clarify it. If you have any doubt, any query, you can share with me and you can clarify the doubt. Otherwise, you have to be ready with the answers. I'm going to ask you basic question, because I have to monitor your learning, whether you are learning or not. Okay, so my questions are essential. Otherwise, it will be only one way teaching. Okay, if no doubts, then I can go ahead. Yes, one query is there now. What is on y-axis? Why on y-axis we have percent response? Okay. EC50 is anybody? Yes, anyone can answer this question. EC50. Is anyone from you?
Concentration to exert.
See, Trupti, your voice is not clear. Trupti, your voice is not. Namira, can you repeat?
Concentration of drug that will give 250% of the effect.
250 or 50%?
50, 50, 50.
So, see, EC50, the term itself explaining effective concentration. How much effective concentration to give 50% of the response? Okay, they say now you can take example muscle contraction. If the muscle contraction is 10 mm, okay, the decrease muscle contraction is 10 mm. So that is 100% response. Okay, so if you are reduce, if the concentration which is giving the response by 50%, the concentration which is giving 5 mm of contraction, okay, 10 mm to 5 mm, so that concentration, the concentration which is giving contraction of 5 mm, so that is called as 50% of the response. Okay, so 50%, the concentration which gives 50% of the response is called as EC50 value. Yes, any other question? Okay, fine. Now, see, whatever the questions are, you can post it, but my objective is the whole concept is should be clear to you. Okay, now we can move to the next slide. See, bioessay procedures are generally employed. Okay, when we are using bioessay, when the chemical assay for the substance is not available, okay, or the substance is inactivated by interacting with the chemicals. Okay, see, these are in general points. Okay, so I'm not going into the details, but when we are studying the exact animal model, so where you can understand why we are using animal model. See, in animal model, for example, if you are going for a decrease in blood glucose level, okay, so in body there are so many variations, variables are there, but the same condition you cannot bring into the test tube. Okay, so every time chemical assay is not a suitable option, you have to go for biological assay. Okay, because finally that drug is going to be used in human being, so you have to try that drug in animal's body so that you can have an idea of effect of other variables on the blood glucose level. Okay, so chemical assay, even if it is available, but it that chemical assay is having its own limitation, because in chemical in test tube you will be having only glucose and your drug. Okay, but actually that drug is going to be used in human body, and in human body you're not having only glucose, you are having other hormones, other biomolecules. So you have to assess your drug in presence of all variables. So that's why chemical assay is not, if it is not available, or if even if it is available, so you have to go to the biological or bio assay. Then second, when the quantity of the sample is too low, okay, when the quantity of the sample is too low, in such a situation matching type of bio assay is conveniently done to compare the biological response with the standard. Okay, now see, if the sample is too low, so in this case we have to go for matching bio assay. Now what is matching bio assay? We are going to see in further slides or in next experiment. Okay, so at this stage you just remember bio assay is a type of bio assay which is preferred when the quantity of the sample is too small. Then next objective is to estimate the concentration of active principle present in the tissue extract and endogenous mediator like acetylcholine, 5-HT and prostaglandin. Okay, so if you want to estimate the active principle present in the tissue, okay, present in the tissue, so for this you have to use bioassay. Chemical assay is not possible. Okay, then to measure the pharmacological activity of new or chemically unidentified substance. Just now I have given you example of blood glucose level. Okay, decrease in blood glucose level. Okay, whether it is decreasing or not, so that can be identified. That is nothing but a pharmacological activity. So that can be find out with the help of bioassay. To measure the drug toxicity. Okay, this is again possible with the help of bioassay only. Then when the bioassay is more sensitive than chemical assay. Okay, so if the bioassay is more sensitive, then you can go with the chemical assay. Okay, so these are the conditions where you have to go for bioassay method. Okay, now see the advantage. The first advantage is, the first advantage is it helps in, it is essential in development of new drug. Okay, it is a prerequisite, it is required. Bioassay study in animal, it is required in development of new drug. In the preclinical assessment, okay, if you can recall the drug discovery process, so one of the phase in drug discovery process is preclinical assessment. Okay, now in preclinical assessment you have to compare the biological activity of the known standard with the unknown compound. Okay, you have to compare. Just say for example you have taken one unknown drug, okay, unknown drug, and you have used a standard drug. Just you can take example of the aspirin. Okay, so you can compare the effect of your unknown drug with the aspirin, because this is well set drug. Next, now in such studies the test must be simple, reproducible and economical. Okay, whatever the test you have selected, so that test should be simple, reproducible. Okay, what is reproducibility? For example, you have completed one experiment and you have drawn some conclusion. So if somebody else want to know that, so he that result should be reproducible. Okay, and at the same time it should be economical. Then biological assessment of new compound. Okay, generally it generates a profile of a drug. Okay, you can take example like in pharmacognosy lab, you have extracted a new molecule. Okay, then that new molecule is not having any record of pharmacological activity. So what you are doing now, you are finding out the effect of that drug on central nervous system with the help of animal study. For example, you have find out the anti-anxiety effect of that drug or CNS depressant effect of that drug. Then you have found out the anti-epileptic effect of that drug. Okay, so means you are constructing a profile of the activities, whether it is activating the CNS system or depressing the CNS system, whether it is having any anti-epileptic effect or not, that is not a matter. The matter is you have performed the study and you have constructed a profile that okay, so and so drug is new and it is not having anti-epileptic effect or it is not having CNS depressant effect. Why? Because it is not crossing the central, it may not cross the central blood-brain barrier. Okay, so that profile you can construct with the help of this preclinical method. The last one is such profile. Okay, whatever the profile you have developed, such profile can guide the clinical testing. Okay, so these are the advantages of the bioassay method. Now see, you can go through this drug discovery process. So now see, this is the preclinical phase. Okay, in vitro, in vivo, and ex vivo assay. Okay, so this is our aim to understand this portion, and you can understand the importance now. This is in the drug discovery process. Without this, you cannot go ahead. Okay, then after this phase, you will be having clinical development. In clinical development, you will be having different phases, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3. Then again, other studies are there, safety and efficacy. Now see, this safety and efficacy, again, you can correlate this with in vitro, in vivo activity. We have toxicity studies. Okay, so this toxicity studies can come into in vitro and in vivo studies. Okay, so this is a drug discovery process. Any doubt till this point?
So
okay, any other student? Okay, if no doubt, then we can go ahead. See, use of standards. Okay, use of standards. Can you remember, we have used one standard in pharmacology 1 in experiment which are based on Coquillium, that is bioassay interpolation method. Can you remember the standard drug? Yes, anybody? 18 pH 39, Raza. Are you there, Raza?
Yes, sir.
कुछ याद आ रहा है? कुछ हमने किया था interpolation method के अंदर Coquillium use करके. उसमें standard drug कौन सा था? One person है
मास्टर. नहीं याद है, sir.
Okay. Azmat, 18 pH 31.
Yes, sir.
कौन सा स्टैंडर्ड ड्रग यूज किए थे हमने?
ड्रग सर,
बायोएसे जब हमने किया था ना इंट्रापोलेशन मेथड Coquillium के थ्रू.
आइडिया नहीं है, याद नहीं आ रहा सर.
याद नहीं आ रहा है. खान अब्दुल रज़ाक, unmute yourself. Yes. Abdul Razak, are you there? 18 pH 29. See, if you're not answering on my call, so I will be considering you as absent. Yes, Khan Abdul
Razak, 18 PH 29. If you are having any mic issue, then you can write in chat box. Okay, that is also acceptable. Eighteen PS 38 Mohammed.
किया तो था बट याद नहीं आ रहा.
Okay, see the answer is already it is the answers are there in chat box. Most of the students have given correct answer, like Trupti, she has given right answer, but she is having doubt. Okay, then 18 PH 42, she has given correct answer. 18 PH 53, correct answer. Again, she is having doubt. 18 PH 53. See, the standard drug what we have used is was acetylcholine. Okay, याद आ रहा है अजमत अभी? एसिटिलकोलीन, अब्दुल रजा, देन मोहम्मद.
यस सर, यस सर.
एसिटिलकोलीन शकील भाई बना बना कर देते थे आपको, और आप लोग यूज करते थे कॉक इलियम के ऊपर. तो वो क्या था? एसिटिलकोलीन कोई नया ड्रग नहीं है. एसिटिलकोलीन इट्स ओल्ड ड्रग, इट इज वेल सेट ड्रग. तो हम क्या करते थे कि आपको एक अननोन भी देते थे. ओके, अगर आपने परफॉर्म किया होगा अननोन वाला भी, तो अननोन that unknown may be anything. Unknown वो कुछ भी हो सकता है आपका. तो unknown has to compare with the standard drug. And we have used acetylcholine as a standard drug. Why? Because acetylcholine is a well set drug. Okay, सबको पता है, it is given in pharmacology, pharmacopoeia. Okay, it is complying with the all the standards, and we are hiring, we are purchasing it from approved vendor. Okay, तो वो पूरा standard है. तो जब भी हम कोई बायो एसे करेंगे, सो वी हैव टू कंपेयर अवर रिस्पॉन्सेस विद द स्टैंडर्ड ड्रग. ओके, सो दैट इज स्टैंडर्ड. तो उससे होता क्या है कि जैसे देखो, नाउ आई विल गो थ्रू इट. ओके, सी द फर्स्ट पॉइंट. इट इज बायो एसे आर डिजाइंड टू मेजर द रिलेटिव पोटेंसी ऑफ टू प्रिपरेशन. रिलेटिव पोटेंसी मीन्स वी हैव टू कंपेयर इट विद द स्टैंडर्ड. Okay, then what is the standard? It's a pure substance as per the standard of the pharmacopoeia, and standard substance helps in solving the problems arising from the biological variation. Jaise agar aap ka ek set hai, you are using one set of the experiment to conduct the experiment on cock ileum. So on the same situation, same conditions, you are exposing your standard and your unknown. So whatever the variations are there in your setup, so that can be equalized. वो जो भी variations है, तो variations आपके लिए standard के लिए भी वही है और test के लिए भी वही है. Okay, जैसे you can take example of the bubbling bubble, number of bubble per minute. If it is more than 60, तो it will be similar for standard and unknown. Okay, if length of the cock ileum, for example, length of the cock ileum should be 0.5 centimeter, and you have not maintained it, you have taken 1 centimeter. Okay, so that is similar for both the drugs. Okay, then you can take example of the thyroid solution. Thyroid solution, if the thyroid solution is having more sodium level, more sodium concentration, NaCl level, so that more sodium or extra sodium will be similar for both the प्रिपरेशन. अननोन के लिए भी रहेगा, स्टैंडर्ड के लिए भी वही रहेगा. तो जो भी वेरिएशन है, सो दैट वेरिएशंस कैन बी इक्वलाइज. ओके, वेरिएशन विल बी सेम फॉर द स्टैंडर्ड एज वेल एज फॉर द अननोन. सो दैट इज द एडवांटेज ऑफ यूजिंग स्टैंडर्ड. ओके, सो द ऑब्जर्व रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ अननोन वुड बी ऑलवेज रिलेटेड टू द इफेक्ट ऑफ. सो दिस इज द मीनिंग व्हाट आई हैव एक्सप्लेन टू यू, कि जो भी आप रिस्पॉन्स ले रहे हो, इट शुड बी रिलेटेड टू द स्टैंडर्ड. Okay, now see the types of bioassays are there. There are two types of bioassay. One is quantile and another one is graded. Now, what is quantile? Quantile is all or none phenomena. You can take example insulin induced hypoglycemia. Okay, so this is giving hypoglycemia. So, and then cardiac arrest caused by digitalis. So it will be cardiac arrest present or absent, hypoglycemic convulsion present or absent.
Okay, so that's what is called as all or none response. But in second case, in graded response, now see, in graded response, you will be having gradually you are increasing the concentration of the drug. Okay, gradually you are increasing concentration of the drug, and as the concentration is increasing, the response is increasing. जैसे यहाँ पर हमने देखा था, ऐसे ग्राफ हमने देखा था. ओके, यहाँ पर क्या था, कॉन्सेंट्रेशन था. ओके, सो एज द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इज इंक्रीजिंग, ओके, द रिस्पॉन्स इज ग्रेजुअली इट इज इंक्रीजिंग, बट एट सर्टेन पॉइंट वो जाकर क्या होता है कि पूरा स्लोप आ जाता है. दैट इज अ डिफरेंट स्टोरी. बट यहाँ तक जो रहेगा वो क्या रहेगा, एज द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इज इंक्रीजिंग, योर रिस्पॉन्स इज इंक्रीजिंग. So this is called as graded response. Okay? No. Now, the choice of the response is depending upon the precision of the assay. Okay? आपको जो भी assay find out करना है, आपको जो select करना है, it depends on the accuracy and reproducibility of the assay. Okay? Then quantity of the sample available and availability of the experimental animal. अगर आपके पास animal ही नहीं है, तो आप क्या करोगे? आप एनिमल नहीं है तो फिर आप दूसरा कुछ कर सकते हो, जैसे सेल लाइन को देखना पड़ेगा आपको. अब सेल लाइन अगर अवेलेबल नहीं है, देन यू हैव टू गो फॉर एनिमल स्टडी. ओके, एनिमल नहीं अगर अवेलेबल है, अगर ऑर्गन अवेलेबल है, देन यू हैव टू गो फॉर ऑर्गन्स. ओके, तो ऑल दीज आर द स्ट्रेटजीज. अगर आप अगेन द मेथड डिपेंड्स ऑन द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द एनिमल्स एंड अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द ऑर्गन्स. यस, इज इट क्लियर? Types of bioassay. There may be chances
sir,
of some.
Quantal assay. Sir, quantal assay explain करिए
ना. Yes. See, quantal assay is all or none. Okay, all or none. जैसे again I'll give you example. जैसे अभी जैसे इसी के अंदर example दिया insulin. Okay. If you have given insulin, तो क्या होगा कि hypoglycemia होगा या नहीं होगा. Okay. तो almost होता ही है, insulin से होगा ही है. बट अगर आपने एक नया ड्रग दिया है, ओके, एंड दैट न्यू ड्रग इज आइदर इट इज डिक्रीजिंग द ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल और नॉट डिक्रीजिंग द ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल. ओके, तो एक ही कॉन्सेंट्रेशन आपने दिया और उसी कॉन्सेंट्रेशन के अंदर आप क्या कर रहे हो कि जज कर रहे हो कि ये डिक्रीज कर रहा है या नहीं कर रहा है. तो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ऑल और नन. एक ही कॉन्सेंट्रेशन आप दे रहे हो, बट ग्रेडेड में ऐसा नहीं करते हम. ग्रेडेड में क्या करते हम कि कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इंक्रीज करते हैं, जैसे 2 microgram per ml, 4 microgram per ml, 8 microgram per ml, 16 microgram per ml, और then we are observing the response. Okay, so that's why it is called as graded. Okay, we are giving different grades of the concentrations, and in all or none we are giving only one drug, one concentration, and we are observing the response, whether the response is present or not. Okay, जैसे अभी ये cardiac arrest digitalis आपने दिया, तो कार्डियक अरेस्ट होगा ही होगा. ओके, बिकॉज डिजिटलिस इज वेल नोन फॉर कार्डियक अरेस्ट. ओके, बट सी, डिजिटलिस इज इट्स अ कार्डियोटॉनिक. ओके, इट इज अ कार्डियोटॉनिक, सो यू हैव टू असेस वेदर इट इज गिविंग द कार्डियक अरेस्ट और नॉट. ओके, तो इट विल नॉट गिव यू कार्डियक अरेस्ट. बट जैसे अननोन ड्रग अगर आप दे रहे हो, अननोन ड्रग देने के बाद अगर कार्डियक अरेस्ट होता है या नहीं होता है, तो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ऑल और नन फेनोमेना. तो बहुत सारे केसेस के अंदर हम लोग ऑल और नन भी यूज करते हैं, और बहुत सारे केसेस में ग्रेडेड रिस्पॉन्स भी यूज करते हैं. यस, इज इट क्लियर? ओके सर, कैन यू प्लीज अगेन प्रिसीजन ऑफ एसे डिमांड. ओके ओके, see one question is there in chat box, can you please explain again precision of assay demand, precision of assay. okay fine. See, precision and accuracy, okay, these are the two terms. accuracy mein kaise hota hai na ki aapko dekhna hota hai ki aapka jo assay hai wo kitna accurate hai. jaise I'll give you one example, jaise mujhe estimate karna hai protein level. okay, to main kya karunga ki एक सैंपल बनाऊंगा, और उस सैंपल के अंदर क्या करूंगा मैं कि नोन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन डालूंगा. जैसे मुझे मालूम है कि इसके अंदर जो है 1 microgram कॉन्सेंट्रेशन है. अब मैं क्या करूंगा, वो मेथड कर देखूंगा, और वो मेथड करने के बाद एब्जॉर्बेंस लेकर देखूंगा,
और एब्जॉर्बेंस के बाद कैलकुलेशन करूंगा, और कैलकुलेशन के बाद जो है मैं उसका कॉन्सेंट्रेशन कैलकुलेट करूंगा कि कितना आता है, 1 ग्राम से वो कितना डेविएट हो रहा है. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एक्यूरेसी, कितना उसका एक्यूरेसी आ रहा है. ओके, और प्रिसिशन के अंदर भी जो है हम लोगों को एक पूरा एक सेट ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट है. जैसे मॉर्निंग के अंदर हम कुछ सैंपल लेंगे, आफ्टरनून में कुछ सैंपल लेंगे, इवनिंग में कुछ सैंपल लेंगे, अलग अलग कॉन्सेंट्रेशन के सैंपल लेंगे, और उसके बाद हम क्या करेंगे उसको उसके अंदर स्टैटिक्स लगाएंगे और स्टैटिक्स लगा कर देखेंगे कि वो कितना प्रिसाइज है. ओके, कितना रिप्रोड्यूस कर रहा है. ओके, तो दिस कम्स अंडर वैलिडेशन ऑफ द मेथड. ओके, वैलिडेशन ऑफ द मेथड. बट मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम कैसे होता है ना कि हमको जो एक्सपेरिमेंट करना होता है वो वेल सेट एक्सपेरिमेंट होता है, तो उसमें इतना ज़्यादा वैलिडेट करने की ज़रूरत नहीं होती है. बट अगर आप रिसर्च के लिए जा रहे हो, रिसर्च के लिए जा रहे हो, तो नो डाउट यू हैव टू वैलिडेट योर मेथड्स. ओके, सो एक्यूरेसी एंड प्रिसिशन. ओके, एक्यूरेसी एंड प्रिसिशन बोथ आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर मेथड वैलिडेशन. आपको आपका मेथड वैलिडेट करना पड़ेगा कोई भी रिसर्च स्टार्ट करने से पहले, और उसके प्रोसीजर्स होते हैं, वो प्रोसीजर्स आपको फॉलो करना पड़ेगा. जैसे मैंने एक एग्जाम्पल दिया कि आपको नॉन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन आप ले लो और उसको पूरा ऐसे कर देखो कि उसके अंदर जो है कैसे रिजल्ट आ रहा है. ओके, यस, एनी अदर क्वेश्चन? ओके, सो वी कैन मूव अहेड. दिस विल बी द लास्ट स्लाइड, लास्ट बिटवीन स्लाइड. ओके, so types of biases, so these are the types: matching, interpolation, bracketing, multiple point. So we have performed this one, bracketing and all these in these experiments we are going to perform in these practicals, 3 point, 4 point, 6 point. Okay, so all these we have to perform in this pharmacology 2, and at that time I will be explaining you in detail what are the matching, interpolation and all. Okay, so error in vitro base in bioassay, so there are chances of error in vitro bioassay method. Okay, like factor contributing to errors are syringe, unstable baseline, spontaneous mobility of the tissue, temperature, volume of the bath and erratic responses. Okay, so all these are the errors. Okay, jaise aapne khud kiya hai, jaise syringe ke andar aap measure kar rahe ho, to measurement kabhi ऊपर नीचे हो सकता है. सिरिंज का भी जो है आपको कैलिब्रेशन करना पड़ेगा. बेसलाइन कभी ऐसा होता है कि स्टेबल होती है, कभी अनस्टेबल होती है. ओके, टिश्यू मोबाइल हो जाता है. अगर आपने एरेशन ज़्यादा कर दिया तो टिश्यू मोबाइल हो जाता है, कोई ज़्यादा मोबिलिटी आ जाती है उसके अंदर, स्टेबिलिटी नहीं होती है. ओके, टेम्परेचर है, वॉल्यूम ऑफ बाथ है, तो ये वेरिएशन है. रिस्पॉन्स जो है इरेटिक आते हैं. ओके, कभी ठीक आते हैं, कभी नहीं आते. So all these are the possibilities. All these are the possibilities of error in the bioassay. Okay. So this much is there in today's practical. So I have explained you in detail the introductory part. So from next session we are going to start with the actual experimentations, and from next experiment also I am going to give you assignments and Viva will be taken. Okay. So right now, see, I'm preparing one Google Classroom. So what you have to do, first of all, you have to join Google Classroom. Then I am sending this to you, okay? This PowerPoint to you. So you just go through this PowerPoint, okay? In next practicals, we will be conducting Viva based on this introduction, okay? So within 5 minutes I'm going to share with you Google Classroom code. Okay, so for see the assignment, see as we are having practicals for almost 3 hours, so I will be sending you this, so you just go through it, okay? Go through it and WhatsApp me if you have any doubt.
Okay, okay sir.
Chal, theek. So just start writing your roll numbers in chat box. Okay, and simultaneously you can leave the class. हेलो यस अदर स्टूडेंट्स राइट डाउन सीट नंबर योर रोल नंबर्स 18 पेज 29 32 37 write down and you can leave if you are not having any doubts any queries any questions then you can leave
Sir, sir, please explain erratic response one more time, sir, please.
Which one?
Sir, erratic response.
See, erratic response means improper response. जैसे तुमने किया होगा ना मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम कैसे होता है ना कि जैसे यू कैन रिकॉल दैट सब मैक्सिमल रिस्पॉन्स ओके तो सब मैक्सिमल रिस्पॉन्स में कैसे होता था ना कि वो रिप्रोड्यूसिबल नहीं होता था ओके तो जैसे पॉइंट 2.4.1 से स्टार्ट किया हमने 0.1.1 रिपीट किया देन 0.2.4.8 1.6 और 3.2 ओके 1.6 और 3.2 वी आर हैविंग सीलिंग इफेक्ट ओके
सर
तो 0.4 जो है ना जब हम वापस लेते थे ना तो वो रिप्रोड्यूसेबल नहीं होता था
हां सर यस सर यस सर
तो ये दिस इज इरेटिक रिस्पांस ऐसा भी एक चांस है दूसरा कैसे होता है ना कि कभी ऐसा होता है कि 0.4 0.1 0.2 0.4 ये ग्रेजुअली इट इज इंक्रीजिंग और 0.8 जो है डिक्रीज हो जाता है 0.8 डिक्रीज हो जाता है और फिर 1.6 बराबर आ जाएगा तो ये सारे जो है ना ये कैसे होता है ना कि दीज आर द सम एरर्स अब इसको लेकर चलना पड़ता है ना ये थोड़ा सा एक इशू आता है बायोवेसी के अंदर तो ऐसा होता है कभी कभी ऐसा होता है कि सेल जो टिश्यू है वो डेड हो जाता है ऑक्सीजन की नहीं मिला डेड हो गया तो अभी क्या करोगे आपके बीच में डेड हो गया तो सारे प्रॉब्लम्स होते हैं उसमें दैट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड कि भाई ये एरर्स है इसके अंदर
ओके सर थैंक यू सर
ओके वेलकम ओके इफ यू हैव रिटन योर रोल नंबर्स देन यू कैन लीव अब्दुल रजाक तो है ही नहीं देन 37 आई डोंट नो Name is not given here. Sayyed Aman. Yes, Abdul Razak, are you there? 18 PH 37. I am noting down absent.
Sir, 18 PH 52 is there. Aman
is there, yeah. Aman is there, but these two are not responding, na? Means what? They are not there. Oh. ओके अमन अली यू कैन लीव अगर आपको कुछ डाउट नहीं है हाँ कुछ डाउट नहीं है तो यू कैन लीव
ओके सर थैंक यू
दिस टू स्टूडेंट्स आर एब्सेंट